So just look at the board. I have three different problems again from exponents, and I mentioned it as 20 ABC. Last class we discussed different important problems as 19 and 18. Okay, see previously. Right now, just 20th A. A by b to the power x minus 1 is equals to b by a to the power x minus 3. Then we need to find the value of x. Right, it's very simple. One side the base is a by b, and the other side the base is b by a. So a by b and b by a are reciprocal to one another. We need to rewrite any side of the base which equals to the other one. See, what I do is, yeah, a by b to the power x minus 1 is left side, and now I will rewrite right side b by a. I will rewrite right side b by a as a by b to the power minus 1. Is there anything wrong? A by b to the power minus 1 is simply nothing but b by a, and its power x minus 3 is also given, to the power x minus 3. Our target is to find the value of x. Just observe here. One side I have a by b power x minus 1, and other side I have b by a power x minus 3. But to get equal bases, I just rewrite this b by a as a by b power minus 1. Now, left side, a by b power x minus 1. Again, right side, a by b power, you just multiply these two, m into n. Minus 1 into x is minus x, minus into minus is plus 3. Now, when you observe both sides, since bases equal, you just equalize the powers. So x minus 1 is equals to minus x plus 3. We need to get the value of x. Send minus x this side and minus 1 that side. See, x plus x is equals to 3 plus 1. 2x is equals to 4 and x is equals to 2. There ends your problem. Once again, have a look. This is the problem, and the bases are different in both sides. One side I have a by b, other side I have b by a. So to make equal bases, I just rewrite this b by a as a by b power minus 1. And then using the laws of exponents, like something power m into m power n, we need to multiply these powers. So minus 1 into x minus 3 is minus x plus 3. And on that we get that x is equals to 2. That's the problem. Right? And afterwards, you just think about b. I will solve b and then I will solve c also. Right? Have a look. I am arranging this. Just have a screenshot for this bit 20th A. Next thing is 20th B. Okay, this is also a problem from your practice sheet. Xy to the power p minus 1 is equals to a, xy to the power q minus 1 is b, x into y to the power r minus 1 is c. Just observe this, all these three are symmetrical. A is equals to x into y power p minus 1, b is equals to x into y power q minus 1, whereas c is equals to x into y power r minus 1. And we need to multiply a power q minus r, a power r minus p, a power p minus q, and we need to show the product as 1. For that, initially start with a power q minus r. Consider a power q minus r. And what is a actually? A is x into y power p minus 1, and this is whole to the power q minus 1. When you observe, a, this is the product, this is one term, this is the other term, and whole to the power q minus r. We have different laws of exponents with us. First, suppose if you have a b whole to the power m is equals to a power m into b power m. By this law, you just rewrite it like x power q minus r into y power p minus 1 to the power q minus 1. See, this second term to the power q minus r means we will get the product of these two. So p minus 1 into q minus r. So a power q minus r is x power q minus r into y power p minus 1 into q minus r. This is a power q minus r. In the same way, we have a chance to write a power r minus p as well a power p minus q. Okay, this is not a, so the problem is, yeah, right. This is not a everywhere. Here it is a, right? And here we need to take b, and here we need to take c. Okay, a power q minus r, b power r minus q, and c power p minus q.
since it is a power q minus r, this is x power q minus r into y power that. And now similarly, if you calculate b power r minus p, we will get x power r minus p into y power q minus 1 into r minus p. Again, c power p minus q in the same way. This value to the power p minus q. First thing is x. X to the power p minus q. And the second thing is y power r minus 1. So, y power r minus 1 into p minus q. So, I have a power q minus r, b power r minus p, c power p minus q, but I need the product of these three. So, consider, you just start your discussion with left hand side of the required one. Left hand side is what? A power q minus r into b power r minus p into c power p minus q. And we need to simplify it as 1. So, a power q minus r, this, what is this? X power q minus r into y power p minus 1 into q minus r. This is a into b power r minus p is this. What is that? X power r minus p into y power q minus 1 into r minus p. Again into x power p minus q into y power r minus 1 into p minus q. You just collect x terms and y terms separately. In one bracket, if you collect x terms, x power q minus r into x power r minus p into x power p minus q you will get. And in the other bracket, you will just collect y power terms. There are three terms, right? Everything is the product. And this side, see, when you observe this side, since base is equal, you just add the powers. You will get this as 1. See, minus r plus r gets cancelled. Minus p gets cancelled. Q and minus q gets cancelled. This is 1. And in the same way, that bracket is also 1. At the end, the product is 1. After this step, the simplification needs your algebraic skill. If you are perfect at algebra, then do it easily. If you are not perfect, then first of all, learn the additions and multiplications of algebra and then simplify this problem. Okay? Yes. Then look at the next problem, 20th C. Here I have x power y is equals to y power x. One relation is given. And the other relation is x is equals to 2y. Using these two relations, we need to calculate the value of y. Just have a look how to calculate the value of y. X power y is equals to y power x and x is equals to 2y, right? I will just try to replace x with 2y. You just use x is equals to 2y here. From there, we will get what? X power y. X means 2y to the power y. And this side, y power x. X means 2y. So just replace x with 2y. So 2y to the power y is equals to y power 2y. Okay? Right. See, both sides we need to use the laws. This side, 2y power y, that means what? By the laws of exponents, as we know, 2 power y into y power y. And this side, y power 2y. This y power 2y can be written as 2y means y plus y, right? This y power 2y can be written as y power y into y power y. Is there anything wrong? Left side, 2y power y. A b power m. A power m into b power m. So 2 power y into y power y. Right side. Since base is equal, if you add the powers, you will get y power 2y again. And now when you observe, this is 2 power y into y power y. That is y power y into y power y. You just cancel out 1 y power y both sides. And then you left with what? You left with the 2 power y is equals to y power y. And again, if you look, since powers are equal, we need to equalize the bases. And our value of y is 2. There is the problem. Since y is 2, you will get x as 4. Right? So, we will solve these type of problems in this way. Right? The value of y is 2. Just have a look. Look at the board. Another simple problem as 20th D. And for this problem, it is given that a cube plus b cube plus c cube is equals to 3abc, and our requirement is to prove this left side part is equals to x cube. So very simple. See, there are in the left side we need to multiply three terms, and you just observe the powers here: a square, b power minus 1, c power minus 1. See, first of all, I will simplify that: a square, b power minus 1, c power minus 1. Very simple. This is a square, and we know b power minus 1 is 1 by b, c power minus 1 is 1 by c, and so we have a square by bc as this power. So with this idea, you just start with the left side, and left side it is x power a square, b power minus 1, c power minus 1, x power b square, c power minus 1, a power minus 1, x power c square, a power minus 1, b power minus 1 is the given left side, and this is equals to x power. Here a square, b power minus 1, c power minus 1 is simply a square by bc into x power. If you rewrite it, you will get it as b square by ca into x power c square by ab. And now here, since the bases are equal, you just add the powers: x power a square by bc plus b square by ca plus c square by ab. Right? Simply I added the powers since bases equal. And now you just simplify these three terms. You just took LCM. LCM of the denominators. What are the denominators? BC, CA, and AB. The LCM is ABC. If LCM is ABC, already here I have BC, so I need to multiply with A. So we will get here it is A cube plus B cube plus C cube divided by ABC. Okay? If you wish, just check it. A cube by ABC, A square by BC, B cube by ABC, B square by CA, C cube by ABC, C square by AB. Okay? And now you just use this given relation. A cube plus B cube plus C cube is given as 3ABC. Rewrite this numerator as 3ABC divided by ABC. So 3ABC divided by ABC. ABC and ABC gets cancelled. We left with X cube, and that's the right side. There ends the problem. You just have a look. Another simple problem from exponents. Okay?